Blackstone presents The Guardian by Joshua Hood. This book is read by Scott Brick. Chapter 1. Camp Lemonnier, Djibouti. Staff Sergeant Travis Lane stepped outside the hangar, the East African sun hot as a blast furnace against his skin. During his 12 years as an Air Force pararescueman, Lane had conducted combat operations in some of the world's most unforgiving environments and had thought he knew a thing or two about privation. But Camp Lemonnier had been quick to prove him wrong. Located on the southern side of the Djibouti Ambouli International Airport, a rifle shot from the Gulf of Aden, the camp was close enough to both Yemen and Somalia that it was the perfect choice for prosecuting America's war against the terrorist groups that plagued the Horn of Africa. But its tactical advantages aside, Camp Lemonnier was an undeniable shithole, the kind of place a soldier's morale went to die, and since his arrival 3 months earlier, all Lane could think about was getting back to the States. Already sweating, he decided to forego his usual stretches and, after starting the timer on his watch, pushed himself into a jog. Lane ran east, his surgically repaired knee tight as a bowstring. Ignoring the pain, the 29-year-old PJ slipped past the candy-striped sawhorses and no foot traffic sign that guarded the entrance to the cargo apron, and once clear of the fence, he looped around the tail of a recently arrived C-130. The exhaust from the turboprops scalded his lungs, but Lane kept running, weaving his way through a line of olive-drab forklifts that crisscrossed the flight line like mechanized ants. Feeling his knee loosening up, he increased his pace, and leaving the superheated tarmac behind, he followed the gravel path south toward the razor-wire-topped wall that encircled the Joint Special Operations Command compound. He nodded to the men guarding the gate and glanced inside as he ran past, the sight of the bearded operators mingling around the Tactical Operations Center sending his thoughts back to his time with the elite 24th STS. Before joining the Air Force, Lane hadn't known the differences between a rescue squadron and a special tactics squadron. In fact, all he'd known about Air Force pararescue was that, like most special operations, the PJs had come of age in the dark days of Vietnam. But while the SEALs and Rangers were out in the jungle taking the fight to the enemy, the PJs were rescuing pilots shot down behind enemy lines. But more important than a PJ's training was his mindset, his willingness to rope into a hostile area, fight his way through the enemy, and provide the medical care required to keep the injured alive until the cavalry arrived to get them out. "These things we do, that others may live." That was their motto, the oath written in blood that had captured Lane's attention so many years ago. Making it through the PJ's grueling 2-year pipeline had damn near killed him, but Lane had succeeded, and after donning the coveted maroon beret, he'd felt 10 feet tall. Invincible. It wasn't until he went to Afghanistan and saw the operators from the 24th in action that Lane realized the best was yet to come. On paper, there was nothing to separate one special tactics squadron from another, but Lane and the hardened few who'd survived the grueling selection process of the 24th found themselves in rarefied air. As members of the Air Force's only Tier 1 team, the men of the 24th STS were the best of the best, the tip of the spear whose lethality and medical proficiency had earned them the right to join the operators from SEAL Team 6 and Delta Force on America's most classified missions. Lane had spent the next 5 years putting foot to ass for the good old US of A, but then on a nighttime hostage rescue mission in northern Iraq, everything had gone wrong. He could remember little from that fateful night. The heat of the explosion when the RPG hit the tail rotor, the screams of the pilot and the kaleidoscope of earth and sky as the helo spun toward the ground. Then everything went black. His next memory was of the hospital in Germany.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.